Hi friends, this is Subrat here. So this is the fourth tutorial on my Python series. So today I'm going to cover what is Python identifiers. So let's begin. So a Python identifier is a name used to identify a particular variable, function, class, module or other object. If I say in general, to identify or to specify a particular things in real life, we need some name or some address to it. So then only when you want them, we can call by their names or we can go to their address and get the things done. So similarly, in case of Python also, to access a particular variable, function, class or module or other objects, we need some name of it. So by using that name only, we can access those objects. So generally I can say that identifiers are the name given to the particular things. So there are some specific rule and regulation we need to follow to declare an identifier. So here I have mentioned some of them. So first one is alphabet symbols are allowed in the identifier, both the uppercase and lowercase. So let us understand these things with some examples so you guys will be clear on it. So I am defining the first rule, which say alphabet symbols are allowed. Suppose I am declaring a variable by using only alphabet symbols like ABC equal to 10. So here ABC is an identifier. So I have given the name called ABC. I have used only alphabetical symbols. Here I have used only uppercase symbol. So let us use lowercase symbol and declare the variable ABC equal to 20. So this way I can declare my identifier. I have used both uppercase and lowercase symbols to declare my identifier. This is the one of the rule that I can specify to declare an identifier. So second rule is saying digits are also allowed in the identifier. So I can also use digit from 0 to 9. Suppose ABC 55 also I can declare as an identifier. Small ABC 65 also I can use as an identifier. So here the second rule is saying that I can also use the digits from 0 to 9. But one more restriction here is that you can't use the digits. While declaring the identifier, first you can't use the digits as initial places. Suppose I want to declare an identifier like 78 variable equal to 60, then it will give me syntax error. So here the one more restriction is that initially you can't use the digits as the initial places in the identifier. So identifier can't start with the digits. So here I have given some examples, total 1 to 3 and 1 to 3 total. So here two are different things. Total 1 to 3 is the valid identifier, but 1 to 3 total isn't a valid identifier. So identifier are case sensitive in nature. Means ABC, capital ABC 10 and small ABC 10 are two different things. Suppose I am declaring ABC equal to 20 and small ABC equal to 30. So both are two different things. How I am saying that both are different? Because the memory allocated by the ABC will be different than the memory location of the small ABC. To check the what is the memory location of the ABC, I can use one predefined function called ID function. So I'll be telling all those in details about these predefined functions and all in future tutorials. So this is for my reference only. So I want to know the what is the memory location of the small ABC and capital ABC. I can use the ID function. So here you can say that both the memory locations are different. That's why I'm saying that identifiers are case sensitive. So third rule is underscore symbols we can use also. So Python compiler allows us to use the underscore symbols inside the identifier. You can place underscore at any place. At first place, if I am putting underscore variable equal to 30, it is a valid identifier. And in middle also, in between also, I can put one underscore and it is also a valid identifier. At last also, I can put one underscore, it is also valid identifier. The underscore symbol you can put at any place to define an identifier. So this is the third rule which I have discussed. So the fourth rule is saying that starting an identifier with a single leading underscore indicates that the identifier is private. So one thing I wanted to say, in other programming languages like C, C++, Java, C#, and .NET, they have the concepts called public, private, and protected. So they are restricting the identifiers to be public, to be private, and to be protected. But in case of Python, we don't have such restrictions. And suppose you want to implement the restriction, and you can do that by using the underscore symbols. So there is no hard and fast rule to implement the private, public, and protected identifiers. So informally only you are saying that if I want to declare a private variable, you have to use the single underscore before it. Suppose in my function, I want to declare a private variable, private equal to 30. So I can use the single identifier on it. So here, if I'm printing the private and calling the function, so it is giving me the private variable. So generally the meaning of private is that the variable can only be accessed within a block. It cannot be accessed outside. Here only formally you are saying that I want this variable as to be private. We are not forcefully implementing it. You can also access this variable outside also. So let us see how you can access the variable outside. Generally the public, private, and protected concepts comes if you are declaring the variables inside a class or function. So suppose I am declaring a class, my class. Suppose I want the variable inside the class to be private. And I am creating an object of it. So in details I will be explaining what is the class and objects in future tutorials. So this is the example for my reference purpose only. My class obj dot underscore var. So here I have implemented var as in private, but I can also access it as an outside also. So here formally you are saying that I want to implement this variable var to be private, but you can also access it outside. So my compiler is not implementing my variable as a private. As a programmer you are saying that I want my variable var to be private. So other person coming and seeing that this is declared as private, they will not use an outside as like this. So this is the way you can declare a private variable. So let us see other rules. So fifth rule is saying starting an identifier when with two leading underscore indicates a strong private identifier. Suppose you want to forcefully implement the my variable to be private, then you can use two underscore instead of one. If I'm using two underscore, I'm forcefully saying the compiler to declare it as a private. I'm not saying my compiler formally to be declared as a private. It will be declared private by the compiler forcefully. If I want to access my private variable, strongly private variable outside, I'll not able to access. It can't read it. So if you want forcefully to declare your variable to be private, then you have to use the double underscore before it. And one sixth rule is saying that starts with two underscore and ends with two underscore, then it is a language specific variable. So what is the language specific variable we need to understand? So Python, what it does, it keeps some identifier to itself for its own purpose. That is called language specific variable. So we cannot use those language specific identifier in our program. So Python, what it does, it reserves those variables for its computation. So the sixth rule is saying that if a identifier starts with two underscore and ends with two underscore, then it is a language specific variable. And the seventh rule is saying that class name should start with an uppercase. So it is a good programming practice to start a class name with an uppercase and other identifier starts with a lowercase letter. So these are the some rules we need to follow to declare an identifier. So let us understand with some more examples. I have next slide, I'll be giving a lot of examples here. So in this example, I am saying that keywords cannot be used as an identifier. So there are some predefined keywords that Python has that we can't use as an identifier. So let us see with an example. So def is the keyword to define a function. So def 30, if I'm giving, it is giving me a syntax error. So if is a keyword to define a if block. If I'm using that, it will give me a syntax error. So keywords cannot be used as an identifier. So the fourth example is saying that maximum allowed length of an identifier. So there is no limit that the identifier name should have. So you can declare a infinite length of identifier. So like this also you can declare an identifier. There is no specific limit that you have to, no specific length that you have to use. So here also I can print the value of this variable. So this is the one interesting thing. In other programming languages, we have some specific length limit, but in case of Python, we don't have some specific length that the identifier should have. So the dollar symbol is not allowed in Python. So the dollar anywhere you can't use as an identifier. So this is an invalid syntax. The dollar symbol you can't use as an identifier. So only underscore also you can use as an identifier. Underscore equal to 50. Then also you can print the underscore value. So alone underscore also you can use an identifier. So I have said that if you want to implement private variables inside a function or inside a class, then you can use the single underscore on it. And if you want to implement strong privacy, then you have to use double underscore before it. So this is the examples what I am saying. So I have also said that there are some reserved identifier that are used by the Python. So one of the example is init. Init is reserved method in the Python to initialize some variables. So this is the all about Python identifiers and with some examples. So in the next tutorials, I'll be explaining the Python keywords. Thank you.